Hi guys, this is Angel Garachigoya with Beauty and Beast in Business. And today the discussion is why is it easier to take a no than it is to continue to fight for something that you believe in? And I was actually asked that question by my husband this week. He said, Angel, do you do a lot of Or do you make a lot of your choices based on the fact that this is what you teach to other people? Or is there another reason why sometimes you don't take the no when it's so much easier to kind of forget that option and kind of go on to something else? And I had to think about it for just a second. And I said, no, I don't do it because this is something that I teach. I do it because I think it's the right thing to do. And it's not always the easy thing to do. And sometimes when I believe that I've been told no, or that other people have been told no, we have to continue. We have to continue to strive. We have to ask why. What do I need to get a yes? And if this isn't the right community, maybe there's another community out there for me. And not only that, all of the strides that we make in government, all of the strides that we make in passing laws that are better for people, better for the equality, better for businesses to be treated the same and people to be treated the same, that has all been done from those of us and those of you who don't take no for an answer, who push that envelope and say, no, this is for the greater good. So as you are making decisions on your career, on your life, on how to navigate, and you're not happy with the no, I want you to sit down and I want you to think about, what is my why? Why is it that I want this thing? And do I deserve it? Do the people around me deserve it? Do the community and do my skill sets and all of these things that kind of play into this decision, how does that lead you? Because if we take a no and we're not happy with it, that one leaves us stressed. It leaves anxiety. It leads to microaggressions. It leads to passive aggressive discussions and communications with people because we're not happy with that. So if you feel that you're on the road to something bigger and something better for you or for your family or for your community or for passing certain laws and equality and diversity and people equity and all of these good things, I want you to remember that sometimes it's not the easy road. Most times it's not the easy road. We're not simply handed these things. We have to continue to move forward and we need to continue to work towards what it is that we want to accomplish. So today I want you to think about your why, and I want you to be proud of pushing the envelope, of making sure that you know your skills, your expertise, your education, your heart, your mission, why you do the things that you do, what your value is and your worth, why you deserve specific things, and how you can continue to work and grow towards them. So, from me to you, sending much love from Beauty and Beast in Business.